My name is Matthias Hartmann. I live in Austria, in Salzburg. I've been working with Alexander Pereira for some years, also already in Zurich, later in Mailand at La Scala. Now I'm happy to be here in Florence. Beautiful place. Fidelio is an opera that I have done once before. I did it in Geneva, and quite an interesting interpretation, because in the end, when Florestan is freed, suddenly, with the end of the music, he turns to become Pizarro himself. So it was an evil ending, and in this way I have the feeling that I have done all the interpretation work already on this opera. I didn't feel like changing anything content-wise. I appreciated it being like it is, and the challenge I have working on this opera is something completely different. We were facing the challenge of taking this opera to a new stage, which is small and does not have the opportunity of moving technically. We are working literally with no decor. And what I'm experiencing now and what I'm experimenting with is, where does an opera staging begin and where does a concert end? And how ambivalent is this borderline? When you work on an opera and you see that you don't need a lot, actually. Operas often have enormous pictures and gigantic images, and you are impressed by the way music and big pictures harmonize. And with this staging, I'm working on how much is needed and what little do I actually need to tell the story. So it's all on the characters. Every movement is very, very precious. Everybody who moves from one spot to the next does exactly know why he's doing it. Otherwise, it would not work on that limited little space that we're working on. It is all about the borderline, the ambivalence between concert and opera. I often get asked what kind of modern, new or different interpretation I have in respect of the work I do on operas. And I must say that I'm more and more convinced that opera does not need any justification. I don't want to push myself into the spotlight by saying, I found a new way of how to deal with this opera. This is not interesting for me at all. I am a servant to the music. The content is, as it always was, timeless and good. The way I interpret it is because I am like I am and I live as a modern person in society. And what I do comes out of me, and I don't need to prove that opera is modern. Opera is modern anyway. To work with Zubin Mehta is a tremendous experience, and it's the first time I meet him. Of course, I heard a lot about him, but meeting him is something different. He is not only that he is a legend, but Zubin Mehta is a person of great humor. He has an enormous sense for quality. He often comes to the rehearsals, which I very much appreciate. And you know, when a legend comes to your rehearsals, you may think, will he be content with what I'm doing? Should I be frightened that he criticizes me? Not at all. He sat there in a very modest and very curious way. He often smiled and laughed when he liked something very much, and he encouraged everybody to be courageous. People who expect in the auditorium an opera with a big visual effect will not find what they're looking for. But of course, music-wise, it is a wonderful place to be. And if you want to be part of something so pure, so literally done with nothing, and if you want to participate on a process of purification, then that's the right evening for you.